Hey guys, Corey here. Welcome back to Corporate Muscle TV. Today I've got a job that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 rooms, stairs, it looks like, hall, and there's probably a master closet in here somewhere. Anyway, I'm going to talk about the gliders that come with Challenger today. People have always asked questions about it, and I've never really went over it, at least I haven't in a long time. So I brought them all in, and I've got some here that I think they've added that are new. But anyway, we're going to take a quick look at them all and kind of go over the theory of why you use them. Let's take a look. Take a look around the house here. I'm upstairs. Usually the stairs out. All right, we got bedroom here. Another one here. There's a few issues in this one. I don't see it being anything I can't handle. And there's a bedroom to the left and the right here. It's all mild issues, nothing. It's a different type of carpet. I don't remember seeing this ever. I mean, this is just, and it's different. It wouldn't be probably a pleasure to patch. I think you might not be able to hide it in there if I was gonna patch it. But anyway, let's look at the gliders. Now, most of the time you see me using the CD. You know, this is something that I make myself. And for some reason, I can't find where I put them. I have a bunch of these on the van. I just can't find where I put them. Put a little piece of Velcro on it so it holds in place underneath the towel. All right, what it does is it allows the machine to get up its RPM, and it gives it a little bit of slip on the carpet. It takes away some traction, and it gives the machine a little bit more slip. The machine is obviously happier, you know, traveling at its, you know, said RPM, whatever that is. It's a 175 machine, I'm pretty sure, but it's orbiting. But anyway, to get the RPM up and have it run comfortably, put these gliders under it. Now the gliders, let's see here, thin, holy, so this one's thin, thick, and a little bit less. All right, so this guy here, this is the super thin one, all right? It allows you to take basically, it's a 15 inch driver in the machine. The pad here is 20. So what it does is it basically, this part will be down on the carpet. It allows it to slip. What you're doing is you're taking cleaning surface away from the machine. So you're increasing the RPM and allowing it to slip a little on the carpet. All right, now this one says a thin one here. Now, over here, you can see the difference between a thick one and a thin one. Now the thick one, what it's doing, it's taking the same amount away from the machine, but it's also holding it up a little bit higher. So it'll let the machine travel a little bit higher up. Like if you're cleaning a wool rug and you want to be gentle as you can on the rug, you know, you would use something like this underneath it. These guys here, this is kind of a hybrid, kind of between. Basically, it comes with three. Now, this guy here, it's about the same thickness. It just allows a little contact with the carpet in here. So, most of the time, I use a CD. So, I get a little bit of slip, and you still have, you know, quite a bit of a area to clean with. But, you know, these are your options. The next one up from this one would be probably this one to give you a little bit less. Then there's this guy here that would give you even less cleaning coverage. And then this guy here, this would take the most out of the machine. So your machine would run the highest RPM with a thick one underneath it. Anyway, now they do, you can make them yourself. You can take the lid off a 5-gallon bucket and you can put you some Velcro on it where it'll stick under the machine. You can do them that way. They tend to break quite a bit, but I like having a little more contact with the carpet and just raise the RPM a little bit on the machine. So the CD is just about right. There's just no longevity with the CD, but you know, Tom Petty hadn't worked in years here. So, you know, he can do that. All right, I'm getting ready to start cleaning here. I've got to do a little vacuuming before I start. So I will try to cover that. And as far as up here, as far as the cleaning, the pre-sprayer goes, not crazy heavy. with the pre-spray. This video is not going to cover any chemistry at all. Chemistry is something that you say chemistry, but you're as long as you understand, but the alkaline and the acid side of the pH scale, that's really as far as you need to delve into it. All right, I'm going to let's start back here. So I'm going to shut up for a minute and get the vacuum out and set up the tripod here so I can do some cleaning here. I'm going to do a quick vacuum over here first. All right, we are going to pre-spray one room at a time here and do the cleaning here. This one, I'm going to do it in real time. All right, pre-spray it first. Had a little bit of Fabuloso in there from the other day, so it still smells real good. I've always loved the way Fabuloso smells, and I haven't used it in over a year. And like I always tell everybody, if you're doing VLM cleaning, any mild detergent with peroxide will work fine. You know, sometimes you get into situations where you need more than just a mild detergent, and got that covered too. You know, after you've done this for a while, you know what works, what doesn't, what you're wasting your time with. You know, so you learn how to do this with the components of cleaning rather than buying some pre-spray that was made in somebody's garage and had a label put on it and want $75 for a gallon. So, you know. It has its place. I mean, everybody is starting out, and that's generally what you start out with. Advice from people that cost you quite a bit of money. So, and I did that too in the beginning. I did that too. You'd sell me anything. Anytime I had a question, I'll end up buying something. You know, just ask a question that didn't involve buying something for the answer. So I've talked about that in other videos. I haven't really lately, but I thought I'd mention that. All right, now this guy here, I put the holy driver under it. So it's has a lot of give to it. All right. Just about ready. Turn the fan on. Yeah. every once in a while you hear a little bit of a rattle, and what that is about every six or eight months or so, there's four bolts that will try to vibrate loose. So they're starting to get a little loose, so I need to tighten them up. But basically, well, there's actually three, two on this side and one over here. You just tighten those up and you're fine. And the advice I give is that you tighten them up until the handle will stay up on its own, and you have to force it down. You give it a little squirt of W-40, it'll free it up again, and you're perfect. House by myself, and somebody's ringing the doorbell. All right, one room down, and it turned out really good. You can get a little closer if you want. Got it on heavy, heavy zoom here. That's a peculiar carpet for sure. Said I wouldn't really know if I could hide a repair in that real easily. It looks like it might be difficult to hide a repair in. But I'm not doing any repairing today here. All right, I'm gonna switch over to time-lapse, and then here later I'll switch back to trying to do a little of both. There's a group of guys that like to see the time-lapse, and other people want to watch the cleaning. So trying to settle both. That right there is, it's organic, whatever it is. I don't know exactly what it is, but let me go grab my ammonia right quick. And ammonia, you know, I'll put it on my gravestone if I have to. It is the most effective cleaner probably in the world. The only place I wouldn't recommend using it is on aluminum. I believe it makes a chemical reaction with aluminum. But basically, you know, it leaves zero residue behind, and it's got a pH of 14. So it blasts through everything. And there's no way any carpet supply store is going to tell you that, because it replaces pretty much every spotter they have but for rust remover. rust remover is oxalic acid. The cheap rust remover is hydrofluoric, which is what's the name of that? Wink. Wink rust remover is hydrofluoric acid. But oxalic acid is the one that's been around for 100 years, and that's what they've always used. Now, the kind of rust stuff that those guys use on in mechanic work and stuff on pipes and all that stuff, that's not the same. That won't work. That rust dissolve stuff, it's not for carpet. All right, I'm going to switch over here to time lapse and spray this and clean it right quick, and we'll come back and take a look. All right, we are done in here. Zoom in. That's a little bit much. There, and that right up there, right in there is where all those dots were. Let's see. All right, now got still on a tripod here, so I'm bumping around on the ground with the tripod trying to fit between the machine and the wall here. All right, sorry about that. So I'm gonna back up here, and we're gonna do a little more time lapse. I'm going to set up the camera about right here, and we're gonna do this section of wall here and this room. This room has got whatever that is going on in it. I would assume it's something dog related. The client just bought this house. He lives about 5 minutes away. He buys houses and rents them out, and he's actually gonna move into this one and then rent the other one that he's in. So yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna move some stuff around here. Actually, I'll leave it running since it'll be a time lapse. Watch me work. Turned out really, really, really nice. Got new carpet almost here. This was a little difficult. It will dry a little lighter, but whatever that is, I may give another go at it. I gotta give this more peroxide and soak it down with peroxide again and run the machine over it. It is, it's difficult, whatever it is. It would almost have to be organic, but I'll work with that a little bit more. Anyway, all there's left to do is a little bit right here, the stairs in that room. And I'm gonna go re-up on some peroxide here. All right, now I'm gonna use a new pad on this one here. Now the pads, they're soaking in a little bit of ammonia, water with a little bit of ammonia, so they start to cut as soon as they hit the carpet. So a little more efficient cleaning that way. You don't have to do it that way. I don't know if I should time-lapse this or do it in real time. Part of it in real time, part of it time-lapse. All right, I'm real happy with this. Turned out really well. I'm going to do the stairs, but I'm not going to cover those. The hallway here, all of this. But this was not a tough one by any stretch. So I think the most difficult thing was maybe that right there. All those dots. They were a little more problematic than what I thought. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching. For guys that are interested in getting into this business, I am a dealer for Challenger. I get a commission check, obviously, when I sell a Challenger, so I share a little bit of that with you. I send you $100 back out of that. And then I'm also the guy that you can continue to text after you buy it and get, you know, knowledge about, like, I get texts from guys that have bought them. Like, how do you, the machine's doing this? How do you fix that? And how do you get this out of carpet? What do you do? So you get an answer that doesn't cost you, you know, anything to ask the question, basically. And, you know, and by that, what I mean is, you know, when I started out, every time I had a question about something, bring it by, we'll look at it. Means we'll charge you. Stop by and we got this for you. That'll fix what you need. That'll cost you. So being able to ask somebody a simple question and get a simple answer that doesn't involve a sales ploy, you know, that's worth quite a bit. And I'm sure that nobody's used to that, at least not in this business. I support the small cleaner. I don't support the industry. All right, guys, thanks for watching and God bless. See you on the next video.